I've been making music since very late 70s, very early 80s. I DJ, do a lot of different productions. I use the name Oicho. Oicho's a sumo wrestler. You know a sumo wrestler? So their hair is tied up in a sort of top knot. As you see the little top knot? It's like DJ top knot. There's my studio, part of my studio in LA. We do a lot of music to picture, a lot of international productions. So if we're looking up here, this is a sort of bloated version of a course we teach in LA. From left to right, I've got four what I call record decks. Taking a kind of classic Richie Horton approach, running four record decks, a drum machine, a sequencer, and maybe some other stuff. This is the Ableton version. I'm gonna do you a snippet tonight, but if I just scroll down. So each of these little sections here, this is kind of one track. And the idea is that we go sort of left to right. This stuff over here is gonna fit with this stuff over here. This stuff over here is gonna fit with this stuff over here. So we sort of zigzag down. So we're gonna do a short snippet, but if I scroll down to give you an idea of how long a set, we keep going. I think we're about halfway. So I've done 4 hours. That was a challenge. Every time it's different. You know, the great thing about Ableton is that we don't have to make all those sort of decisions that we don't want to make straight away. Like, how long is this? What's going to happen next? You know, what you're seeing there is probably 3 to 4 months of pre-production. Once that's done, then you're good for a year or so. You know, before I get kind of bored and go, oh, you know, we need to put some new stuff in. But using this as a template in the class, we sort of built, I don't want to say simpler versions, but, you know, more immediate versions. And this works with pretty much any genre. And we've done this with sort of trap, with minimal techno, with house, with, you know, all kind of stuff. Of even sort of taking rock sets and cutting sections up and really moving into sort of starting to make new tracks of our own. So I would think 50% of this music in the four decks is mine. About 30% is pieces from other tracks, other people's music. And then the last 20% is sort of some taking some things from other people's music and then really cutting them up and making them into new loops. You know, just Magpie, just picking and mixing and saying, oh, I like this piece. As a producer, as a programmer, whatever you want to call yourself, I always love working with real DJs because they come in the studio and they've got 5 records and they say, this works, and this works. And what they mean is they've done product testing. They play this in front of 5,000 people 100 times and seen what the reactions are. And that, you know, you can't beat that. So, you know, I'm not saying you copy these things, but you say this is a good point to start with, right? What I usually have is a couple of drum machines, but for the sake of my luggage allowance, I've got one kit. Where are you, little kit? Somewhere, here we go. There's one kit over here with all kind of drum sounds. Some of these things have effects chains behind them. Using some of the new tools in Ableton 10 and some of the CV and gate tools. And I'm a big fan of the effects racks. And we'll talk about some of these effects racks. So the Oicho tool version 2, as you see down here, I'm sorry this is a little small, but I think you can just about see what's going on here. If we open one of these up, you'll see a whole range of effects running beat repeats, running what's inside some of these. These are what we call nested. With these effects racks, we can build effects racks and put those effects racks inside effects racks. Some of these are so nested now that I struggle to find the bottom. They are all go back to one set of 8 knobs, a filter, some kind of stutter, what I call a twist, some kind of metal delay, some different kind of beat repeats, a sweep delay, what I call a sweep delay, which let's see if we can just trigger one thing so we can see what a sweep delay does. So this is a triggering a whole cascade of different effects inside different effects racks, which are then routed back to the main one, so we can do four or five things with one button. Now, using some of the new CV and gate tools that Ableton has just released, I've been messing around with them for a while with the beta versions, but there's finally a sort of stable version that I'm confident enough to run these things and it not crash, because some of the beta ones were really a little glitchy. A combination of those, a Eurorack module called Expert Sleepers, which gives us DC coupled audio in and out, which means we can send both audio signals backwards and forwards, and CV and gate signals backwards and forwards. Some of you guys are doing the sound design, so you're getting CV control voltage and gate. Very, very simple. If we think of a light switch, it's a gate, right? It's a trigger and a gate. It's opening a circuit, closing a circuit. Dimmer switch, we're amplitude control, right? How much volume we're sending backwards and forwards. So this module allows us to send CV and gate, as well as audio and gate. And it gives me four inputs and eight outputs. All these channels are coming in through here from Ableton. The main outputs are coming in here. They're going through a couple of filters and a couple of external delay units, as well as the three or four that are set up over here. There's one that's going to this super magneto Strymon. What can I say about it? It's the best Euro rack. We can really mangle these sounds up. I try and amuse myself as much as anything else. I don't like to play the same set twice. What else have we got set up over here? Well, I've been using a Lima system on an iPad, but I don't know, this whole touch screen stuff, it's fine in a thing like this, but you're a sweaty nightclub in the middle of the night and there's water coming down your arm. I still like to have some knob control. And this is just basically running those eight channels up there. I really try and keep this down to sort of eight the most. It fits in the push two grid. Sort of got to the point now that can really turn the screen off altogether and just look at what's going on here. This has got a few different kind of dub delay things going on. So we should be able to keep that going for as long as we like. And you've got to be a little careful with that one. Before all of these push and launch pads and stuff, there's a guy called Brian from California made these things called a monome, which is just a kind of open source grid. And you can do with it, you know, what you like. There's lots of Max programs, some sequencer programs. And we can think of this as, you know, the faders, if you want, or separate grids in separate sections. What I've got here is running a channel of samples. There we go, that one down here, which is an effects rack.
If one man die, all man dead.
So I've got a lot of vocal
ask
stuff.
Ask me question, I tell you no lie. Ask me no question. play music.
It's very satisfying, press the button and it lights up, and that's pretty much all the monom itself does. But it's a, you know, a great controller. So we can kind of grab some of these.
Love in your neighbor's world.
So we can grab this and now we can angle this around as much as we like, right? And this is all because these are on. Because this is all going back to these beat repeats, and each one of these beat repeats is, there's about five or six beat repeats in a row that are mapped to different stages of this one button. So we move this one button and it turns one off, turns the next one on, etc., to this whole row of them. And so we can kind of grab these little things and kind of make a sort of, footworky sort of vibe going on. And everything, because these are all set in grids, they're all running in time with Ableton, so we can grab some of these things. With a low pass filter on one side and a high pass filter on the other, we can really start making these do all kind of different things. Get it? Right? So, I have another big modular rig of modules, kind of Euro rack stuff. I didn't want to bring that amount of stuff, so I spent a while going through and recording. I gave myself four different variations of sequences that will run along with whatever rhythms are in this section. Some of them are like 32 bars, some of them are a minute long. Find myself doing the same thing with those sequences anyway, opening filters, cutting sounds down. So I sort of do a performance and capture those. And if we trigger one of those. What I try to do is do 16s, 12s. Kind of more acid-y filter version, and then one that was a little bit more sort of ambient. And I've tried to be as flexible as I can with this set, and I've managed to actually do ambient events. So just really filtering out beats and really just spacing everything out. And then I also get to play at the dub club, so I try and less with coming with the weirdness and a little bit more with the bottom end and sort of bass and some good Prince Farai samples. We have a club in a local club in LA that till recently called Low End Theory. That was sort of my Wednesday night local. I sort of would go down there, listen to music, and just hear what the new stuff was happening. And the 20 years I've lived in LA, there is now a electronic music scene. You know, people are moving to LA from Berlin, which is, you know, unheard of, right? And I got to play at Low End Theory sort of regularly, and it was really good to me to play to people who had no idea who I was, what I was doing in the 90s and the zeros. It really of no interest to anyone who's 18 years old, but you have to come with a good set. You get a 30-minute set, and so you can't be doing a 20-minute warm-up because they've gone to the bar. So it was good for me to kind of hone a sort of small version down too, and it's been really inspiring. A lot of really interesting new sound coming out of LA now, which is, it used to be 80s big hair and rock, and that was about it. But so we got a lot going on there now. It's kind of interesting. So anyway, row of sounds, and each one of these channels has its own separate set of the effects racks. So we can... alter these ones seriously too, and you know, really mangle this into the frequencies that you want to find, as well as grabbing little pieces. This sends a feed to a set of effects on here too, so I can kind of open a channel which goes through a delay and a reverb and a thing called a clouds, which I really don't know even how you can describe it, but it just sort of does a lot of weird mangled stuff. It's got some buttons that you sort of twist and it will change it subtly. Sometimes it just takes off, which I enjoy its unpredictable nature, you know. I don't really want to play the same tunes every night. I did years of playing the same tunes every night. And when you're, you know, standing there thinking about what's for dinner, I think it's time to get move somewhere else. So we can really affect these. So that's a big rack that's sitting over here. So anyway, enough. Let me do a little of this for you. Just a short, let's see where we go kind of set. And I hope you enjoy it. So.
I'm gonna set about 70% of the design.
Thank you.